Hello and welcome to my channel, Bible Vlogbox. This video is a continuation on my series about facts that the Roman Catholic Church doesn't want you to know. If you would like to watch it from the beginning, just click on the link in the upper left-hand corner of the screen or in the description box. I'll include a link to the next part of my series in the upper right-hand corner once I publish it as well. I now give you fact number 8. The Jesuit priesthood is dangerous and evil. The Society of Jesus, more commonly referred to as the Jesuits, is a military order of the Roman Catholic Church. They were sanctioned in 1540 AD by Pope Paul III with one mandate, to defeat Protestantism and regain global papal rule. They have various methods of accomplishing this, including their educational system and infiltration of churches and governments, and they have been successful to a great degree, so much so that most of the Protestant world today accepts a prophetic interpretation of the apocalypse called Futurism, which was invented by the Jesuit Francisco Ribera in 1591 AD to take the attention off of the papacy as the little horn antichrist of the Bible. I go into more detail about that in part 6 of this series. The Vatican is also greatly prospering politically. The papacy is one of the most powerful religio-political organizations and influence centers in the world. Malachi Martin, consummate Vatican insider and intelligence expert, reveals the following in his best-selling book, The Keys of This Blood. The Pope is as determined to be world ruler as was Constantine in his day. He is protected by 4 governments. He is the best-known person of the 20th century. He is personal friends with the leaders of 91 countries. People of the world seem ready to accept him for strong worldwide moral government with control. And papal structure is prepared for worldwide rule now. This was all, to a great degree, accomplished by the actions of the Jesuits. But those actions weren't always noble or moral. The Jesuits have a very sordid history and a negative opinion about their past operations. This is because they are willing to do anything, no matter how criminal, to accomplish their goals. It's part of their belief that the end justifies the means. For example, have you ever heard of the Jesuit Oath of Extreme Induction? It's recorded in the Congressional Record of the United States. If you haven't read it, I'll leave a link to it in the description box, along with the rest of my sources. You should really read the whole thing, but here's an excerpt from it. I furthermore promise and declare that I will, when opportunity present, make and wage relentless war, secretly or openly, against all heretics, Protestants, and liberals, as I am directed to do, to extirpate and exterminate them from the face of the whole earth, and that I will spare neither age, sex, or condition, and that I will hang, waste, boil, flay, strangle, and bury alive these infamous heretics, rip up the stomachs and wombs of their women, and crush their infants' heads against the walls, in order to annihilate forever their execrable race, that when the same cannot be done openly, I will secretly use the poisoned cup, the strangulation cord, the steel of the poignard, or the leaden bullet, regardless of the honor, rank, dignity, or authority of the person or persons, whatever may be their condition in life, either public or private, as I at any time may be directed so to do by any agent of the Pope or superior of the Brotherhood of the Holy Faith of the Society of Jesus. This is the Jesuit oath that members of the order must take when elevated to the rank of commander. By the way, Pope Francis was a Jesuit commander in Argentina before becoming Pope, and according to some critics, he acted the part in the 30-year Dirty War of Argentina. It is claimed that Pope Francis, then called Jorge Mario Bergoglio, was complicit in the anti-communist campaign of the Argentinian military to cleanse the country of communism, which led to the deaths of up to 30,000 people and included kidnappings and torture between the years of 1976 to 1983. Pope Francis denies his guilt, but it wouldn't be far-fetched, because there were other known priests who enthusiastically collaborated with the Argentinian military regime, who committed horrific abuses. For example, Father Christian von Wernich, a former police chaplain, was sentenced to life in prison for his involvement in 7 murders, 42 abductions, and 31 cases of torture. In the past, in England, the Jesuits attempted to undermine Protestantism and assassinate Queen Elizabeth I, a Protestant, a hit which was sanctioned by Pope Gregory. As a result, in 1584, all Jesuits were ordered to leave England. This was all documented in the public office in London. When King James I came to the throne, the Jesuits planned what became known as the Gunpowder Plot in 1605 to blow up the king. Guy Fawkes was their tool. Most of the Jesuits who were behind this foul deed were arrested when the plot was discovered and hanged. By the middle of the 18th century, the Jesuits had been expelled from at least 83 countries, city-states, and cities for engaging in political intrigue and subversive plots against the welfare of the state. The Jesuits are known for their deception, spying, infiltration, assassination, and inciting revolutions. They worked deep into the political field and plotted through politics throughout the world countries. The Jesuits are even suspected of being behind the assassinations of former United States Presidents Abraham Lincoln and John F. Kennedy. In the book 50 Years in the Church of Rome, Abraham Lincoln was quoted as saying, "It is not against the Americans of the South alone I am fighting. It is more against the Pope of Rome, his perfidious Jesuits, and their blind and bloodthirsty slaves that we have to defend ourselves." It is interesting to note that Abraham Lincoln's murderer, John Wilkes Booth, was a Roman Catholic by religion. I can go on and on about the evils of the Jesuits, including their involvement in both world wars. Books and videos have been made about these subjects, and I'll include a link to some videos I recommend at the end of this video. Now I want to talk a little bit about the founder of the Jesuits, Ignatius of Loyola. He was basically a former Spanish soldier who was wounded in battle and couldn't fight anymore because his leg didn't heal right. So after having a nervous breakdown, he committed himself to the baby Jesus and to Mary to become a soldier for the Catholic Church, a spiritual warrior. He claimed that the secret doctrine of the Catholic Church was revealed to him and had a number of amusing visions, including chasing Satan around like a dog with a stick. At that time, before actually starting the Society of Jesus, the Inquisition had determined that Ignatius of Loyola was a member of the Spanish Illuminati, and he was thrown into jail for some time. This actually happened twice. After he was released, he made his way to Paris, France, and recruited some intelligent young men to start the Jesuit priesthood. That is how the Society of Jesus began, by a delusional member of the Illuminati. So there is definitely an occult connection between the Illuminati and the Catholic Church. As a matter of fact, the Illuminati group which is spoken about the most these days, the Bavarian Illuminati, was started by a former Jesuit professor of canon law named Adam Weishaupt in 1776 AD. Now, Adam Weishaupt claimed to have left the Jesuits before founding the Bavarian Illuminati, but that could also well be an excuse to distance the Vatican from the Illuminati so that when the Vatican does something insidious through the Illuminati, it is the Illuminati that takes the blame while the Vatican stays hidden in the shadows. There's one more thing I want to touch on before ending this video, and that's the Black Pope. The Black Pope is an unofficial title given to the Superior General of the Society of Jesus, who is Adolfo Nicholas. He is called the Black Pope because he holds just as much power or more as the White Pope, Pope Francis. Also, the Black Pope stands in the shadows while the White Pope is the public figure of the Roman Catholic Church. The Black Pope is also said to be in control of obscene wealth in various political and secret societies. Political societies such as the United Nations, NATO, the European Commission, the Council on Foreign Relations, various central banks, big corporations, and secret services. Secret societies he is said to manage include the Illuminati, Freemasons, and Opus Dei. The Society of Jesus is an evil and dangerous society of the Catholic Church who works by underhand methods in order to destroy Protestantism and bring the world under the power of the papacy. Just like in the days of the Dark Ages, when the Catholic Church used the state to rule over people by oppression. The Society of Jesus is a very dangerous and diabolical group, and it is important for the Christian world to know about their existence and understand how they operate in order to avoid their snares. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching. Subscribe if you're new, and feel free to like me on Facebook. Also, if you enjoyed this video, please like it and share it on your social media. God bless.